everybody. It's really lovely to see you. Well, obviously not see you. We can't see you, but you'll be able to see us. Kerry and I have really missed you. But today we've got something really special for you. We're going to talk about the Christingle. Now, I know you've all seen a Christingle with the orange and the candle, but we're just going to talk about it today. But I haven't got an orange, not a real orange, but I have got Kerry. Kerry, can you come in, please, and help me with my talk? Here's Kerry.
Hello, everybody.
And she's not a sumo wrestler, she's an orange.
Look at her.
And the reason that we use an orange at Christingle is we use the round orange to represent the world. Here it is, the world that God created for us. Okay, so thank you very much. And here's our world. And we just need to add a few bits. So the first thing we're going to add is the red ribbon. And I'm going to put this round the middle. Okay. Tie it in a nice bow. Okay. Or a knot. And the red ribbon is used to represent Jesus' blood when he died for us on the cross. Okay? And then I've got four sticks. One. Two, three, four. And the four sticks represent the four seasons that we have. So spring, summer, autumn and winter. And they're all equally important in God's creation. We need the four seasons to exist. So there's our four seasons. And on the end, we've got some fruit. Now, when we make Christingles in church, this is always the best bit because we never use fruit. We always use sweets. We love sweets, don't we, Kerry?
We do.
Okay.
As you can see.
Yes. And it's really good because we're coming up to Lent now. So I expect Kerry's giving up sweets, aren't you?
Chocolate.
So Kerry's giving up chocolate for Lent. But we've got our fruit. And the fruit represents all of God's creations. So it could be food, but it's also the animals, it's the fish, it's the birds, it's us. It's everything in God's creation is represented by the fruit on there. And then our last thing we've got is, let's come behind you, Kerry. Fantastic, a candle! That's right, and of course the candle, hang on, we flame through the middle of it, Kerry. There we go. So the candle represents Jesus as the light of the world. He came when the world was in darkness and he lights the world for us. And to be honest, the world feels a bit dark now, doesn't it, Kerry?
It certainly does. We could do with a bit of light.
We need some light. We really need some light in the world at the moment because life is so difficult for all of us. And what Jesus says is, I am the light of the world, and I've got my candle, but you can also be the light of the world too. You can be little lights in the darkness. You can be like little tea lights, or doing something nice to help other people, which helps bring light into the darkness. So, thank you very much, Kerry, for being a fantastic Christingle orange for us. I do think you perhaps need to give up chocolate, though.
I'm very dear.
Yeah, I think it's getting a bit much now. Here we go. That Christmas chocolate. That's on. Right. Well, thanks for listening. Hope you've had a little bit of a laugh with us. We are going to be doing some more things over the next few weeks, so be looking out for us. And we do hope that very soon we'll be able to meet in person again, because we miss you, don't we, Kerry?
Oh, we really do.
We really do miss you. So, shall we finish with a prayer?
We shall.
Shall we do the Lord's Prayer?
Yes, we can do the Lord's Prayer.
Okay, so you can join in with us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. Bye. Hope to see you soon. Thank you.